streptococci. In this figure, we can see gram-positive cocci in chains because streptococci occur in chains. Strepto means chain. Streptococci are gram-positive. They are catalase negative, which differentiates them from staphylococci. They are cocci in chains or in pairs. And in streptococci, cell division occurs in one plane and the daughter cells remain together. Many streptococci, they occur as commensals in the human body. Several of them also act as pathogens. They cause pyogenic infections. Streptos means twisted or coiled. Example of several species in streptococci include Streptococcus pyogenes, Streptococcus pneumoniae, Streptococcus agalactiae, etc. Catalase positive and catalase negative. Catalase positive are staphylococci and catalase negative are streptococci. Morphology of streptococci. The cocci are spherical or oval in shape, 0.5 to 1 micrometer in chains and in pairs. The chains are longer in the liquid media and smaller in solid media. They are non-motile, non-sporing, and generally they are non-capsulated, but some strains of streptococci can have capsules. Group A and C have hyaluronic acid capsules, while group B and D have polysaccharide capsules. In this figure, you can see streptococci in chains. Cell division taking place in one plane and the daughter cells tending to remain together, which gives rise to a chain-like pattern. Cultural characteristics of streptococci include their aerobes and facultative anaerobes. They grow at 37 degrees Celsius optimally. Fastidious. Fastidious means they require extra nutrition, so they will not grow on nutrient agar. You will need some extra nutrition like blood, serum, egg or albumin to grow them. They grow well in media containing blood and sugars. 10% CO2 favors the growth and hemolysis. Alpha hemolysis and beta hemolysis, both kind of hemolysis can be seen in streptococci. Alpha hemolysis is a 1 to 2 millimeter narrow zone, and beta hemolysis or complete hemolysis is a larger zone, wider zone of complete hemolysis. Streptococci can be classified as aerobe and facultative anaerobes or obligate anaerobes. The obligate anaerobes include peptostreptococci, while the aerobe and facultative anaerobes, they have three categories, alpha, beta and gamma hemolytic. The gamma hemolytic include enterococcus group, that is example Streptococcus faecalis. The alpha hemolytic group includes viridian streptococci and Streptococcus pneumoniae, while the beta hemolytic streptococci include various streptococci which can be grouped in serological groups based on the group specific cell wall polysaccharide. They have been divided into 20 Lancefield groups which include groups A to H and K to V, out of which group A is Streptococcus pyogenes, and this Streptococcus pyogenes or group A beta hemolytic streptococcus is further divided serologically based on MTNR proteins, and Griffith types 1 to 80 have been defined. So this was classification of streptococci. Staphylococci are coagulase positive or negative, and they are catalase positive, while streptococci are catalase negative. And based on hemolysis, we can divide streptococci into various groups. Here note the clear zone of beta hemolysis surrounding the streptococcus colonies when grown on blood agar, that is beta hemolytic streptococcus. Notice the zone of growth inhibition around the bacitracin. Streptococcus pyogenes is bacitracin sensitive, so it will not grow around the bacitracin disc. A throat culture taken from 5-year-old child with streptococcal pharyngitis. The culture shows beta hemolytic streptococci and several non-hemolytic colonies as well. And it shows bacitracin sensitive growth, which is Streptococcus pyogenes. Alpha hemolysis, beta hemolysis and gamma hemolysis. Alpha means incomplete or partial hemolysis in which greenish discoloration takes place. Beta hemolysis means complete hemolysis, and in which complete clearing of the zone of RBCs takes place. And gamma hemolysis means no hemolysis. Biochemical reactions of Streptococcus pyogenes include most sugars fermented, example sorbitol, trehalose, lactose, mentol, maltose, etc. Streptococci are anaerogenic. They do not produce gas during fermentation of sugars. They produce only acid. They are catalase negative. And for sugar fermentation tests, serum peptone waters are used for them. A failure to ferment ribose and PYR test positive are two features of Streptococcus pyogenes, which help us to differentiate it from other streptococci. Normal habitat of streptococci is upper respiratory tract or the intestinal tract or the skin. The various streptococcal species, they occur as commensals in the human body on various skin and mucosal surfaces. Group A streptococcus, that is Streptococcus pyogenes, has various virulence factors which help it to cause disease in the human beings. Capsular hyaluronic acid, group-specific polysaccharide antigen, type-specific protein antigens, the M proteins, the T and R proteins, then other cell surface proteins like protein F, protein G, various exotoxins like exotoxin A and B, the erythrogenic toxin and cardiohepatic toxin, various hemolysins like streptolysin O and S, spreading factors which help it to cause spreading lesions, streptokinase, streptodornase, NADase, hyaluronidase, lipoproteinase, and other extracellular enzymes. Staphylococci generally cause localized infections, while streptococci, they cause spreading infections. So spreading lesions are caused by streptococci because they have various enzymes which help them to spread in the surrounding tissues and lead to spreading lesions, while staphylococci, they cause localized lesions. Now, each different virulence factors have been described in our books. The group-specific polysaccharide antigens of streptococci, they have some similarity with human tissue antigens, and because of that, they can lead to cross-reactivity and inflammation in the human tissues because of cross-reactivity. Example, the heart, it can lead to endocarditis. In the kidney, it can lead to glomerulonephritis, and in the joints, it can lead to arthritis. Because the heart, kidney and joints have certain antigens which are similar to the antigens of streptococci, and so a cross reaction can take place and it can lead to inflammation in these organs. The type specific protein antigens and other cell surface proteins are also there. It has been observed that streptococci with M protein, they are virulent, and those without the M protein are avirulent. Various exotoxins like erythrogenic toxins are produced by streptococci, group A streptococci. Exotoxin A, which is a super antigen, exotoxin B, and cardiohepatic toxin. Various hemolysins, streptolysin S and streptolysin O. Streptolysin O is an oxygen labile and heat labile and lead to complete hemolysis in deep colonies. It is immunogenic. While streptolysin S is oxygen stable, heat stable, it leads to hemolysis on the surface and it is not antigenic. ASO means anti-streptolysin O. So anti-streptolysin O titer is used as a parameter, as a laboratory investigation for streptococcal infections. Various spreading factors are there in streptococci, streptokinase enzyme which lyses fibrin clots and help the bacteria to spread in the surrounding tissues. Streptococcal deoxyribonucleus, it dissolves the DNA of the dead tissues, which also further helps in spread of the infection. Clinical application of streptococcal deoxyribonucleus is that it has been used. Streptokinase and deoxyribonucleus have been used as clinically in liquefying localized collections of thick exudates, example in pneumococcal empyema, NADase enzyme, hyaluronidase enzyme, lipoproteinase enzyme, and other acellular enzymes are also produced by streptococci, which help it to cause spreading lesions in the human body. Now, clinical syndromes caused by streptococci include suppurative infections, acute infections of the respiratory tract, including sore throat and scarlet fever. Skin infections include impetigo, erysipela, cellulitis, and streptococcal pyoderma. Other suppurative infections including purpural sepsis, wounds, lymphadenitis, septicemia, endocarditis, necrotizing fasciitis, otitis media, sinusitis, pneumonia, bacteremia, streptococcal toxic shock syndrome. These are some photographs of streptococcal lesions, streptococcal sore throat and scarlet fever. Pebbly dry rash of scarlet fever, red cheeks giving the appearance of white mustache, typical of scarlet fever. Cellulitis, erysipelas and impetigo. There are two non-suppurative complications caused by streptococcal spirogenes infections. They are acute rheumatic fever and acute glomerulonephritis. They occur after a latent period of 1 to 4 weeks. These are non-suppurative complications, means not pus forming. Other general infections caused by streptococcus are pus forming, but these two conditions caused by streptococcus, they are not pus forming. So they are called non-suppurative complications. They are believed to be due to hypersensitivity reactions to streptococcal antigens. Salient features of acute rheumatic fever and acute post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis have been shown here. The primary infection in case of rheumatic fever is in throat, and a longer latent period is there, and certain serotypes cause this acute rheumatic fever. It has repeated attacks and ASO titer is highly elevated in this condition. And in case of acute post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, a prior skin or throat infection is there. The latent period is shorter, and a prior sensitization is not needed. There are certain serotypes which cause this condition, and repeated attacks are not there in case of glomerulonephritis. And ASO titer is moderate, and the prognosis is good in case of acute post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Erythema nodosum is believed to be a manifestation of hypersensitivity to peptidoglycan of streptococcal cell wall. There are small red nodules under the surface of the skin. In lab diagnosis of streptococcus pyogenes, acute suppurative infections, may sample will be taken from the site of lesion, the swab, pus, blood, etc. For transport of the sample, Pike's medium can be used for streptococci. Pike's medium is as a transport medium for streptococci. It is blood agar with 1:1 and 6 zeros crystal violet and 1:1/16,000 sodium azide. Then microscopy can be done after specimen transport. In microscopy, gram stain will show gram positive cocci in chains. In culture, blood agar can be used. Sheep blood agar is preferred. Small mat or dry colonies surrounded by beta hemolysis. Typing can be done, Lansfield or Griffith typing, for epidemiological purposes. Bacitracin sensitivity is a feature of Streptococcus pyogenes. It can be used as a test. Antigen detection test like ELISA and agglutination test can be used. Antibody detection test can be used, which are actually not very useful as antibodies appear late. Non-suppurative infections, culture of sore throat, throat swab or pus from the skin lesion can be taken. ASO titer greater or equal to 200 units is significant for acute rheumatic fever. And in acute post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, it is not very useful. So ASO titer is useful for acute rheumatic fever. In acute post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, anti-DNase-B is a more reliable indicator. Epidemiology may source of infection in cases and carriers. Carrier can be throat carriers or nasal carriers. Group B, Streptococcus aegyalactiae, causes bovine mastitis. It causes neonatal infections acquired during passage through the birth canal, like bacteremia, pneumonia, meningitis. It can lead to septic abortions, puerperal sepsis. Two tests are useful for group B, that is Streptococcus aegyalactiae: hippurate hydrolysis test and CAMP test. CAMP test positive and negative has been shown here. Group D are enterococci. They are growing at 10 to 45 degrees Celsius, pH 9.6, 6.5% sodium chloride, 40% bile aspirin agar. So these are characteristic features of enterococci, that it can grow in these conditions: high pH, pH 9.6, high salt concentration, 6.5%, high bile concentration, that is 40% bile aspirin agar, and high temperature like up to 45 degrees. So these features are characteristic features of enterococci. Besides, it also gives deep tiny pink colonies on McConkey agar. Then viridin streptococci are there. Viridicris means green, and these viridin streptococci, they live as commensals in the human body, on the skin, in the oral cavity. They can lead to dental caries or endocarditis. Enterococcus in histology, in case of pneumonia, it shows gram-positive cocci in chains. Aspirin test positive and negative is shown here, bile aspirin test. Growth in 6.5% sodium chloride is positive in case of enterococci. And that completes the session. Thank you.